Welcome to the much anticipated Christmas card making week of Webisodes. I have to tell you, Teresa has been making Christmas cards in the hot Arizona sun like a madwoman.
Today we're featuring our new Christmas Dazzles.
Yes.
We have some new three-pack Dazzles too, Snowflakes and Holly. And we have a new template to show you and some new cutting dies.
Right, lots of fun things to mix up. Come play with us. Now, here are the Christmas Dazzles. We'll show you each of them as we get into the project.
Right.
And I do have to say, yes, I know this is leaves. It says fall leaves, but it's okay. We're kind of easing into Christmas. So there are lots of them, as you can see. But let's get into the project. So you want to scoot that away?
I'll take that.
Okay. We are going to start with the snow bears. And they are in black because that way they are going to show up so nicely on papers. Now, this is an older paper pack. This is winter flannel. So it's nice not to forget those excellent uses. And Teresa has done something different to create this background.
Right. She used a distress ink. It's the tumbled glass distress ink that you can see here. And one of these great new little applicators.
They're called a dabber.
A dabber. And what's neat about this is that you can fit it on the end of your finger. I think most people probably could fit that on the end of their finger. And she has this graduated effect of a little bit of, you know, the sky up here. It sort of goes down into the snow. And what she did was just use this, get a little ink on there.
Do you want a craft sheet?
Oh, that's probably a good idea.
Yeah, let me bring it out for you.
And
What would we do without it?
She started up at the top here, get a little ink, and if you want to take a little bit off before you start so it's not too dark, and figure out how much you want to put on there, and you just start at the top adding, and I'm just going to go right on there, because you want that bluer effect up at the top, you see?
Okay.
And as you go, you add more ink and just blend it in together like that.
And the nice thing about the dabbers, what I'm seeing, is that you're not going to get a line like sometimes happens with a cosmetic wedge.
Right,
or
it's got the rounded tip, so it's a lot easier to get a smooth edge.
Okay.
And as you move down, just add a little less ink as you go along and just kind of keep blending it together as you move down. And if you keep that up, then you'll get...
Here is the effect that you have. Works really nicely. I noticed that she did back, and we'll get in close so you can see, just his little hat on the plaid, and the plaid is echoed right there. And look what she has done with that little bluebird. She has backed him on one of the holographic, and we'll show you that later. It's the blue snowflakes. But I also love how she's brought in the dazzles.
Right, the jewel dazzles,
right.
The jewel border dazzles here along. And, you know, this is great that she'll just, one little strip will go and stop, and then the other two will go across.
Do you want to bring that package in of the dazzles, the jewel? Right.
The jewel dazzles.
The blue. Yeah. And this is the one, if you're keeping track, you know that we forgot one color in the border dazzles. And so now it is completely matching the jewel dazzles.
This is teal.
So this is teal. Although to me it looks really blue, but okay.
It sort of depends on which way you turn it.
But I love how those add just the shine to that really sweet little bear.
This is great. And just a little bit of the actual, the jewel dazzles that's put right in the middle of the
insides. And then we've got another little scene on the inside. Same thing with that gradation at the top. So sweet, sweet look. Now, another thing that you can do, and this is going with the Winter Delights paper pack, is add some stickles into his little hat.
Right, so that's easy. First you put the dazzle on cardstock, cut it out, and then you add the stickles afterwards, let it dry.
And I love the phrase that's in there, cold paws, warm hearts.
That's so cute.
Works really well.
Baker's twine here. And
this is the border that's in.
Snow friends stickers.
And then here is another look that Teresa did. And as I said, this time, as with the previous card, she's getting into the winter delight. So nice to see those favorites being used.
I love this card. What I like about it is that here's this matted piece right behind the two bears. So you get that focal, but then you still got a little of the red over here, and she's filling up the area with the Dazzles snowflakes.
Right, and this is the three-pack that we talked about. So it has two sheets of snowflakes.
It's not the same as Mixums.
Right, but it's kind of the same package. So we've got snowflakes in this pearl silver, also in white. And then we have a whole sheet of the jewel dazzles, this time in a blue. And what you end up being able to do is an effect like this. So we've got white snowflakes, we have the pearl silver snowflakes, and we've got the blue accents all through. And there are, I think, almost 600 pieces in that three-pack.
That's great. The fact that those little jewel dazzles go with it, that's what makes it the three-pack. There's something different with it to accent it.
So we've got cold paws, warm hearts here again, and then, wow, don't those snowflakes do a nice job? And I love how she put the little bird
with the heart
right onto the Merry Christmas stamp.
And she's got, Merry Christmas stamp here. Unwrap the magic down below, and another paperback to dazzle there.
How darling. Just wanted to show you a couple more things with those snowflakes. Here it is with a new paper pack called Fresh Frost that you'll see later in the week. But again, mixing the white and the silver pearl snowflakes.
Right. So these are actually right here, there are the innies from the dazzles set inside of that snowflake. I love that. Here's the white, there's the pearl. It's just, here on the corner, there are little
corners
on that sheet as well. Oh, here it is. Right here, there are corner dazzles so that you can use them for
cornering
your card.
So just wanted to show you some other things. And the dazzles, those snowflakes, are large enough that it could go individually on a card. Here it is in the silver. And here's a similar one that we have with the white. So same snowflakes, but they're two different ways.
Look. Yeah. We're even using, it looks like a design toolkit for the covers, but it's just totally different.
So for a happy holiday season, and that works.
Right. Now, beautiful.
We're going to move into the houses.
The North Pole Village.
Right. And that is...
it's done on Christmas suites.
Right. And for some reason I don't have that here, but you'll be seeing that actually on Friday. We're going to have a whole day of Christmas sweets.
So another new paper pack. And I see bordering around the edge here is the red fireworks.
It
holographic
is.
Paper.
Believe it or not, that is what is that matting. So it gives just a flash of color.
Right. A little bit goes a long way.
It does. And here's
the North Pole Village.
And here it is in black and white, so you can really see that whole little scene that you can make.
Right. You can make an entire village. You can use just parts of it to make it go a little further. This actually has some of the snowflakes here. Is a snowflake from that village as well, or is it from the snow?
No, this is for Jewel Dazzles. No.
Yeah, but the little black snowflakes are there, and
so you can really see.
Jewel dazzles.
And also, if you'll notice, that technique that you showed in the front with the snow bears, she's done it in reverse down here, giving a little bit of blue to create a horizon line.
And these were colored in. Now I'm
trying to recall. Spectrum Noir pens.
Right.
And isn't that just placed directly onto this piece of cardstock.
Right.
And so no cutting required. Christmas greetings. On the inside, Teresa has used one of the stamps and more of the dazzles, more of that flash of color.
Just a little
bit. You can see with the holographic fireworks, red fireworks.
Right.
What a surprise. And Teresa wanted to do something really different with those North Pole.
Holiday card, but in different colors. And I think she accomplished it with this.
She did.
Beautiful.
Now, she used botanical etchings, which I would never in my wildest dreams have thought would be Christmas.
For Christmas.
But look what she's done. Also, she has framed it in the lacy rectangle cutting die.
So that's what you're seeing along here. Just beautiful. Tiny. This also is from the cutting die, this small cutout piece, and stamped Merry and Bright. Just the tiny words and phrases.
So it looks very Victorian to me.
Or just a little greeting. I said that wrong. Just a little greeting stamp, I believe.
Very pretty. And on the inside, she's used yet another of the lacy rectangles and more of the village to create a little scene.
Beautiful. Overall, she sprayed the silver glitter dust.
Okay, look at that.
That really gives it that Christmassy effect.
And that is such a Teresa flair. She just loves doing that. And so obviously you do too, because...
And we have that.
We've got it in gold.
Yep.
And we have it in silver.
It's kind of fun to play with.
It is very nice. And the little goes a long
way. I'm
going
to go back right now and say that I know I called the wrong stamp out on that. I think I said tiny little greetings or whatever.
And you were wrong? Okay.
Wrong.
It'll be in the gallery.
It's
you
in
can
the gallery.
See. Almost all the cards will be in the gallery. So just wanted to show you that. Now, going to our triple play with our...
another one of the three-pack dazzles.
Where'd it go?
Which is the three-pack holly dazzles.
Now, in this one, you're going to get two sheets of holly leaves. You can see the light green and the dark green. And then you're going to get a whole sheet of jewel dazzles in a glitter
in red. And the green, they're both the mirror finished.
Mm-hmm.
So they're beautiful.
And in this set, you're going to have 904 pieces, so you can do marvelous things. And here is just taking them, going straight out around a circle. Now, this is one, just a really simple use of them, just placing them out.
Right.
Teresa was not content to do it that way. She wanted to do something more, and I love what she did.
I do too. This is another dazzle. Which are the dazzles?
Yes, she used the twigs and leaves, which I would never have thought of.
Here, I'm going to turn this over so you can see which part of it. Right here, here's the dazzle that she used, this big wreath of twigs.
And look how striking that is with the holly.
She said that she actually added more of the twigs from the dazzle sheet to make it even more going on back there she put the holly leaves on there.
And she chose, there are three sizes of holly leaves, and she did not use the largest. She used the medium and small. And you can see just a smattering of the berries. But
beautiful.
This is, Teresa always does this. There's something that is just so drop-dead gorgeous.
It's surprising. This is on the picnic paper pack, so that's the green that you're seeing.
Oh, is that why I have that over here?
Could be.
Okay, let me
that's
bring it in.
That's one of our newer paper packs.
It is. So
you
this is
You don't
picnic.
Automatically think Christmas when you look at it, but you're able to do that. If you think about colors, you can make different paper packs work for different events.
Which is actually something Teresa wanted to do in our first day of the Week of Webisodes. She wanted to bring in some of our favorites so that we're showing them. And on the inside of her card, she has stamped, and then she's added a smaller little cluster of holly
there. It's beautiful.
Isn't that just striking?
Now that stamp set, that must be from the Christmas greetings.
Yeah. Right. So again, another favorite. Now, Teresa is also going into our... trees. Now, this is called Swirl Christmas Tree. It is a glitter finish. Now, this finish is a little more delicate, so you do have to be a little more careful. With the usual dazzles, you can just peel them up, no problem.
Right.
But just want you to know that they're a little more delicate.
The glitter finish and the mirror finishes.
You just want to
give yourself just a little bit more time with them.
So here it is, and this is the one that's on the package. So we've placed it onto white cardstock and cut right outside the white cardstock and just added some of the jewel dazzles.
This is a great look. I love that free form going in there. And some of it is backed in red, so you can see that little tree
there. A little
bit
in the middle. Isn't it?
Yeah. And then so you've got, here's Christmas Joy down at the bottom. That's also from that dazzle.
Right, it is dazzles. From the Swirl Christmas.
Yeah.
Now let me show you Teresa's version, which is so fun and so shiny. Now she has used two of the holographic papers, which are also new, so we want to show them the silver snowflakes, as you can see in that background. But look
at the green circles. And
look at this. Who would have thought of Christmas?
Well, and it's tone on tone. She put the glitter dazzles right on top of that green holographic paper. So you have to kind of turn it to see it, but it's so beautiful. And then those blue jewel dazzles like ornaments on the tree.
Right, and she did put some of the white snowflakes with the jewel dazzles, that snowflake three-pack, mm-hmm. right in there. And then she's cut this snowbank.
Right, in kind of a free form. I believe right. there's a pattern in the gallery.
I think there is, too.
She usually includes a pattern for anything that's not. So real cut and dried.
Isn't this just lovely? And then on the inside, she has used the new Christmas cheer stamp.
Beautiful?
So we'll finally show that to you.
And that's printed, stamped in a green.
It is. And this is a new type of ink pad from our friends at ColorSnap. And this is called Surfaces. And it is made to, it's kind of like a stays-on. So it goes on lots of surfaces, so slick surfaces, as well as paper, as you can see.
And it comes in different colors. We've been using it a lot lately.
Which is very fun. So the green, there's also red. There are just a whole bunch of different colors. But I just wanted to make sure that you saw that.
And that's with Christmas Cheer, which is our new stamp set.
Right.
And it's just beautiful.
So
it's
very
fun.
It's got
that chalkboard look to it. I love that message. It's wonderful.
And where did she get these lines? Well, they too are on their borders that are on the dazzle pack. So
great.
You're getting,
it's always great to have those thin lines.
Lots of things, yes. Now we have, you're going to scoot those over. Thank you. We have a new template. It's called Easy Sunburst. And how might you put that in with Christmas, you might ask, rightfully so. Well, here's how Teresa did it. Now, one thing I want to tell you about this template is that it has lots of ideas on it, and that's true of really most of our templates.
Sure.
So you're going to see scrapbook pages, you're going to see cards, you're going to see different ideas of how to use this, and of course, complete directions are on the template itself.
Sure. But I can show you real quick
what
she did, for this card.
Okay.
If you want to show, you can see that all of these lines that come on this Easy Sunburst are radiating from this one point.
Right.
And the way she did that is first she cut two pieces of this holographic paper.
And this is the silver snowflakes and blue
snowflakes. Silver snowflakes and blue snowflakes. And these are each 6 inches by 4.5 inches.
Okay.
So here's the blue one.
Was that a question or was that a statement?
I was remembering. And this is going to be your base. So I'm going to set that off to the side right now. This is the one you're going to work with the template. And what Teresa did is she turned it over. So you've got this side. And then you've got the template. And she turned the template over.
Ah.
And she put that converging point, all of the points converge there, down in the lower right-hand corner to make everything come out on the upper left on the lower left-hand corner. You have to actually trace and cut out from the lower right-hand corner. So I'm putting that right down on the point of the card. I'm going to line these pieces up with the card, and then you just start tracing, and you get right on that point. Let me show you there. There we go, and you just start tracing the lines.
Okay.
Which are cut out in your template.
Okay.
Just
pretty
like
simple.
That. Pretty simple. You're going to do that all the way across. And I'm not going to show you how to do it all the way across.
Yeah.
It's pretty obvious. You do that all the way. But I do want to point out, you're looking at the back of this. You see the numbers backwards. But you can see how it's 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm actually going to write those on there.
Oh.
So that when you cut them out, you know which one goes in which order, because it makes a difference as to where it comes off the edge of your card.
And I bet she's doing that because she found it was a really good idea.
It was a really good idea. I don't know how I figured that out. So once you do that, once you have them traced, then you're going to go along and cut along each one of those lines. And this is going to be the point that you're going to cut to. So lay a ruler on here and cut each one of those out. After
Should we
you've
bring
done
this
that,
back?
Yeah. After you've done that, then you have these pieces here. Each one of them has a number on them, and they have.
Because you did exactly what Gail told you and what the template tells you.
And then, so that when you turn them over, you can start layering them. Like here's number one, and one would go like so. Now, what Teresa did is she cut them all out. She laid them all back onto her card like so that she would know where they would go. See, I'm actually going to line up on the edge there up at the top.
So she put every single one back.
She put every single one back.
Even though you know you're only going to use every
other. Right. You're only going to use every other one.
Okay.
And then she took off, you know, one, and then she took this one. and glued it in place.
Okay, so while you've got the measuring there.
Right, and okay. Then you take off, and then you can like leave that one there while you glue this one down. You'll have something to set it next to.
Oh,
and
clever.
Then you remove that one.
Okay.
And then she did that, you know, so that every other one is lined up just perfectly.
And then, of course, you have enough to do a second card. Just cut out another blue.
Because now you can just take... You can take those off,
right.
And you can do the other ones.
You get a two-for-one deal.
Like, I didn't even think of that. Good idea. And when they're all done,
then Teresa put it on her 5 by 6.5 inch card. And she's also added the new 3 lacy labels cutting die. And you can see that that is the largest one going around.
Right. And it's embossed with the Christmas cheer stamp.
Right.
So it's this one right here. May your days be merry. And lots of other stuff on there.
And this is really perfect for the chalkboard look, where you're doing it on black cardstock with the white embossing powder. But look how effective that is, of all things, on holographic.
Paper.
And it's nice to know that you can do that embossing on holographic.
Right.
And notice that Teresa, because she wanted really to play off of the sun ray look and let that those shoot out, she actually cut off part of her cutting die.
Mm-hmm.
Now, somebody out there is going, ooh, that hurts. Well, it's okay. You can use that little bit somewhere else. And, of course, because it's cutting die, you can cut lots more.
Right.
Now, Teresa has put the same, the teal jewel border dazzles along the edge, and I think that does a nice job.
It does nice. It's a nice little scalloped edge effect.
Yeah, and then a ribbon. And then on the inside, very simply
letting the holographic paper be the focus.
Very fun. So fun. I would never in a million years have thought of that. Now, why do I find myself saying that so often?
That's Teresa.
That's Teresa. Teresa has done yet another Christmas card, but this time she has used the lacy rectangle, which we showed you a minute ago.
The Bodacious Bloom.
And the Bodacious Blooms, right? Yeah. Both cutting dies. So Bodacious Blooms, which Teresa designed. And this is one of my favorites.
So here it is on several different papers. So she's got several different looks coming out from underneath.
And she, again, has done just an edge, this time with the silver snowflakes. Now, you certainly could do this card without that. But wow, what a nice little punch it adds.
It's, from a distance you're looking, it's very muted, but you just kind of keep seeing this little bit of shine popping out.
And you're getting that with the crystals too. So that's another nice piece. Now, as we back up just a smidge, you can see that she's used those lacy rectangles as layers. So one on the bottom, and then one here that goes outside of the bottom one.
And here's what she's got, one of the Christmas cheer stamps, and that's in a green.
It is.
In surfaces again. In green. Just beautiful.
And on the inside, again, another of the Bodacious Blooms, and you can see.
I did not recognize the paper pack until you opened it up. Now I know it's red velvet.
It's the 6x6 red velvet.
I was not saying anything, waiting to figure out what that is.
It would come to you, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
and again, you can see the holographic is there around the inside, our sentiment. So
don't be afraid to use flowers with a Christmas sentiment.
Yes,
it works beautifully.
It actually does. I think the Bodacious Blooms really ties that in. Wow. Oh, and we didn't even talk about the ribbon. This is, Teresa does just such a marvelous job with the ribbons. And here it is, just of this wide crepe ribbon gathered up and simply knotted. It's just lovely.
It makes a nice impact, especially with those large blooms. It's beautiful.
Very, very useful and dramatic. Now, we did say that we have just a little touch of the fall, so I want to give it a little bit of a message. Yeah.
Right. So here's the fall leaves mixums, and they come in the 3 different colors, gold, copper, and that gold pearl.
Right. And here's what you can do, is you can literally mix them. Now, you're going to demonstrate that?
Right.
Okay.
Here we go. So with those 3 mixums, you want to start by choosing which one you want to use. Can I borrow you the craft knife?
Sure.
Over there? It's easiest for me to pick them up with a craft knife.
There you go.
And so choose a leaf. And for this one, I'm going to choose this beautiful maple leaf, and you want to start with the center. This is what's suggested by Teresa and by Lene too. Start like that and set that right down on your paper, like so. So that's the vein work of that leaf. Now I'm going to choose a different leaf, maybe the copper one, so you can see them real easy.
But the same design, the same image.
Design.
Okay.
So you're going to surround the inside part of that dazzle with the outer layers.
Okay.
And I just have to get it underneath instead of through the paper. So I'm going to be a little more careful when I'm picking up the foil dazzles, the mirrored dazzles. I'm going to get them started on the different areas so that they won't tear. And make it so that you can see me do this too. Now, here's the interesting part. With the leaves, they are cut in half. So you're not going to get that entire leaf. That would be a little bit unwieldy to work with. So you get half of it. So you could even make a different color on the other half if you want.
You could, although I think in the playing that we've done, it felt like seemed to look better with just changing the vein mixing and matching those.
So I'm just carefully setting it down around the inner part, and then you just lay it down like that.
Then you'll just do the same thing on the other side.
Right.
And so you've done the copper with the gold, and here we've got some other versions, both with the shiny as well as the pearl, and the copper is just a gorgeous, and this is with the rich and spicy paper pack.
Sure. So it says thanks, because you can use it for Thanksgiving before you get to Christmas.
Right, and you've got some solid leaves in there, and I think some acorns too.
Yeah.
So
cute.
So day one, we're off to a great start. Please join us tomorrow with more weeks of Webisodes.
Come on back.